ये Eu quero mato tudo por sabe. Mato. Quem mata tudo tem que querer. Por isso mato tudo que está na medida. Mas mato tudo que é. Agora estou dizendo. Curar-me é marxar. Está aqui no óbvio. Está assim, voar. Força, voar por bem. A casa tem bem cheia. Força na rua. Tem que ficar, não tem esse tal, sai de ser uma espírita. Se tal, está bem. Curar bem. A mim, ওই ভাব যেখানে বর্ষা হবে ওই তার থেকে দূর বর্ষা হচ্ছে তার থেকে দূর কেন দূর মহাপ্রভুকে প্রায় আড়াই 300 বছর পরে কিনারা বিভাগ বিশ্বনাথ 250-300 বছর আর আমি মরুভূমির একটা শুষ্ক গাছ এই মা ধৈর্য রসে আমার হৃদয়কে স্ফূর্তি করে দিয়ে আমার
So for this Kartik in the evening sessions, we'll be here to see my Yogi Kalimini, my Sri Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur. He was there in the second group of Goswami. After very difficult words to the Goswamis, he presented in very easily accessible Sanskrit. Especially three books are alive for me. Three books Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur is especially remembered for. Bhagavatamrita Khan, Ujjwala Dilamani Kiran, and Bhaktivasamrita Sindhu Bindu. Who is the heir? Who is the heir of Sri Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur? That is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Who is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu? Radha Bhakti Sivalitam, known as Krishna Swarupa. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is Krishna covered by the complexion and the emotions of Srimati Radhika. Therefore, in Mangalacharan, Sri Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur is praying for the mercy that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He has described the sequence of bhakti and all Shraddha, Tathasa, and Sangha, etc. From association with sadhus or sadhusanga, then Shraddha will awaken. Shraddha means the determination, I only have to satisfy Krishna. Shraddha Sabda Biswas Koyis Vilinistari Krishna Bhakti Koyal Sav Gan Kandori. I only have to satisfy Krishna by this everything else is satisfied. At the stage of Shraddha, one will rather die than, give up Bhakti or give up Harinam. At the stage of Shraddha, that will lead one to take up shelter of the bona fide Guru. Like the last part, it says, Guru Sushma Sayabhatra Sakharam Dhamma Yajna. By taking shelter of the Guru and receiving diksha from him, one will begin the process of bhajan called bhajan kriya, or the activities of bhajan. By performing bhajan in a proper manner, announcing vritti, or unwanted desires will be removed from the heart. The question comes, if we are doing bhajan for 10 years, 20 years, or 30 years, but still our bhava vasana, or our desire to enjoy material objects and senses, is not going. In fact, we are almost like animals. Despite hearing, that means we are hearing, but we are not practicing what we are hearing. They were offering another liberty conversation of Nista, Ruchi, Bala, and Prabhupada. In this book, Sri Vishwanatha Chakri Thakur has very clearly described each of these stages. The sadhana who hear these topics from the mouth of the Vaishnava can very easily understand what is my present condition, where am I? Have I not been vanquished? Have I reached the stage of Nishtha, Ruchi, or Bhav? We should know that Bhav is Srinathapa, pure spiritual emotion. And when that Bhav feelings, it becomes transformed into Prabhupada. Why has Sri Krishna Charavari Thakur called this book Madhurya Karambini? Karambini means the cloud, especially the cloud which is full of rain, like in the monsoon season. That cloud is full of water. Water means nectar. Nectar here means Krishna Bhakti. The water that falls from the clouds is completely pure, not like the water in the ocean or other places. Therefore, this Krishna Bhakti, there is no lust, no contamination at all. Therefore, when these clouds form a line on the horizon, that is called Medmala. And that rainfall is actually the mercy of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. What is that line of clouds? That is our Guru Parampara. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself, Sri Nityananda, Sri Advaita, Sri Rupa Sanatana, and our Guru Parampara. These are the line of clouds bearing the mercy of Mahaprabhu. And that rainfall itself is the mercy of the clouds, that is the mercy of Gauranga Mahaprabhu. By giving the character and teaching to these devotees, their bhakti will manifest in the heart. Just like the rain will flow, rainfall may flow anywhere. The rainfall is not restricted to good place or bad place. The rain may go anywhere. In the same way, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's mercy is Nirankush. Nirankush means it is not restricted or controlled or limited in any way. That rain falls, forms rivers, and those rivers inundate all areas, and good persons and bad persons also get the rainfall. The mercy of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu falls on all different types of persons. But in the desert, there may be some seed. The desert means our heart, which is near us, which has no bhakti. In that desert, there may be some seed that has come there by some chance. But because of the lack of rainfall, there is no sprout. Therefore, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, not only he gives the rainfall to cause the sprout to appear in the heart of the sadhana, but if that person has no sprout, Mahaprabhu also gives the seed of devotion also. Therefore, Mahaprabhu gives the rain, Mahaprabhu also gives the seed. Examples of this are like Jaga and Mara. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu gave them the seed of pure devotion and they became Mahabharatas. Even offenders like Gopal Champa, Chakrabarti, and others also got the mercy of Mahaprabhu and became pure devotees. Therefore, Kalambini has been discussed. What is Madhurya? That Madhurya is Krishna himself, Rasaraj. His form, his qualities, his pastime are so enchanting, beautiful, and easily catch the mind of everyone who hears them. His childhood pastimes are very sweet. His pastimes with the cowherd boys are more sweet. The pastimes he performs with those in Bhaktsari Ras are even more attractive. And the topmost is those pastimes he performs with the yogis. And the pastimes he performs with Radhika, that is the topmost level of Madhurya.
All Chalka has not been taken in the mouth. All Chalka.
All the sweetness has come in the character of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Therefore, Sri Krishnadas Kaviraj has described, before Mahaprabhu there was bhakti. Great sadhus like Sri Ramanujacharya, Sri Nibhadikya, Vishnu Swami, etc., they preached Hari Bhakti. But that bhakti was full of opulence, knowledge of Bhagavan's tradition. They said that Bhagavan was full of alokipa, means they never performed any human-like pastimes, like in Krishna Lila. Before Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, everyone considered the essence of Bhagavad Tattva to be in the Narayan himself, full of opulence. But Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came and says to Rasmanchadhyaya and his tributaries everywhere, before Mahaprabhu, we have not heard how Madhya Soda punishes Krishna. How the cowboy boys, in 1 second of separation, they weep, where is Kanaya? Where is Kanaya? Therefore, especially the sweetness of Krishna as described in the Srimad Bhagavatam, like Venugi, Brahmagi, Yugagi, that sweetness Chaitanya Mahaprabhu sprayed everywhere like a rainfall. The Sri Krishna Charitamrita Thakur says, because he appeared 300 years after Mahaprabhu, I was very unfortunate. I could not get the direct deluge of the Manasik Gauranga in his Prakatila. Therefore, he says, I am in the desert because he appeared after Mahaprabhu. But still, even before it rains, when the rain is there at some distance and a breeze comes, that breeze is very cooling and refreshing. So even though I am in the desert after Mahaprabhu's appearance, Sri Vishnu Charitamrita Thakur says, the wind or the Manasik Mahaprabhu is still touching me. And that is my heart, which is like a desert. In that desert like heart, by the grace of Mahaprabhu, a very nice tree full of nectar of Hari Bhakti appeared in my heart. Gopinanandi.
और सरकार का दर्शन करने के लिए जाएंगे। ini telah dewa kunjung darah.